Hey everyone, today I'm going to be showing you a cool tool you can use when modeling in Blender called the Knife Tool. So first of all, I'm going to need to add an object. So I'm going to press Shift A, then under Mesh, I'm going to choose Cylinder. Then I'm going to press Tab to go into Edit Mode, and let's say I want to create a big cut through this object. To do that, it would be really simple. All I need to do is press K, and you can see a little knife symbol appears. Then I'll just need to choose a point where I want to start, so I can choose anywhere. I can either snap it to a vertex, or I can just choose a random point on an edge. I'm going to start with a vertex, left click, and then you can see I can pull out this here, and it will snap if you want it to an edge or a vertex. So maybe I'll left click here, and then you can just keep left clicking until you're satisfied with how your cut looks. Now, part that some people struggle with is knowing what to do once you've actually made all the cuts with a knife tool. It's actually very simple. All you need to do is press the Enter key on your computer, and you can see our cut has now been saved. If you want to get rid of some of these edges as well, for example, if you didn't like how it turned out, then I could left click this edge here, shift left click this edge here, and then just press Control X. Control X will not delete the edges, but rather it will dissolve them, meaning it won't destroy too much of the geometry. I'll press 1 to go into vertex select mode, and maybe I'll press Alt left click to select this bottom face here, and then I'll press I to inset. And now probably what I could do is edit this to kind of create a bit of a wedge shape. So maybe I could use my knife tool again, left click here, then left click here. You could also use the join tool if you know how to use that. And then once I'm happy, I can just press enter. Then I can left click this vertex here and press G and Y, for example, to just move along the Y axis. And if I press tab to come back to object mode, you can see I've got a bit of a cutout in my cylinder now. You notice though how I've done this inset first, and that's very important just to make sure we don't have any weird shading issues with a massive N-gon. I am going to be talking about quads, tris, and N-gons in the future, which are the three types of faces you get in 3D and Blender. Another thing you'll notice as well is you can also access the knife tool in the toolbar here in edit mode. So I can left click here and hold, and you can see I can use the knife tool this way as well. But yeah, that pretty much covers the basics of using the knife tool in Blender. If you want to see more videos like this, feel free to check out my 3D Modeling for Absolute Beginners playlist here, where I'm going over all the different features in Blender to get a really good grasp of how to 3D model. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.